Hello, everybody. Thank you for joining us. The survey started off mid-July-ish, late July for us, but actually the core work of it started around end October, early November for us. We spoke to about 50 people based on what the Chris Kopal Committee of Experts issued in July, the NPD framework. So we spoke to a bunch of people, 50 participants across the startup and SMB sector, the investors, legal experts. We chose to do in-depth interviews over Zoom and Google Meet and things like that. We spoke to a lot of people. We recorded all their observations. And then we came up with the research. This is the sort of breakdown of who we spoke to. A lot of founders from the startup industry, people working as product managers, security experts, investors, and lawyers. And this is the domain breakdown. As you can see, it's a fairly representative sort of a breakdown of people across the industries. A couple of cloud sectors, media and entertainment, SaaS, and things like that. And then in December, the committee issued the revised framework, December 16th, actually. So with that, we felt that some of the questions will have to change. So we went back to participants with an updated questionnaire. We sent them the revised questionnaire again, the framework again, and we asked them further questions based on that. Quickly running through research findings. Obviously, the more detailed report is on the HasGeek website. I would urge all of you to please go check it out and read through and sign on if you have any other submissions on that. These are the key concerns that came up from the report. Impact on innovation, a lot of people kept saying this again and again. And it was based on both the first report that was produced in July, and then this revised framework also. People believe that sharing raw data sets either as part of a HVD or in an open access repository could have a chilling effect on their competitive edge. We had questions over how ambiguous and vaguely defined some of the definitions were and how that is going to be a risk for startups. Then we also said, we also found out that a lot of this, the vagueness sort of leads to this idea of overregulation, where people are not sure what it is they're going to comply with and what it is that is being regulated. And that is going to create confusion, which will add to compliance overheads for not just startups, for across the board, for small businesses, for medium and large businesses as well. Some fancy numbers. This is something that we found repeatedly, because the idea of privacy, de-anonymization of personal data, NPD was definitely seen as a privacy risk, not just for individuals and individuals, but also for businesses themselves. So this is the concerns in the revised NPD framework as of December 2020. So based on what we've researched, we have a set of very short set of conclusions and recommendations that we are presenting based on research. It's what the community is telling us. Definitions definitely need a complete overhaul, will need to be strengthened and made firm. The fact that non-personal data does not exist in either or state, and that it occupies a larger spectrum, is coming through in a lot of our research. And one way to do that is to have extensive consultations and interactions with the community, with the tech community, with the experts even academic experts and things like that. So that's sort of one recommendation. This is again, the NPDA is seen as both enforcing and enabling, and that could be seen as too strict a control. And so we need to look at how to free up some of that, and the fact that there is a sovereign purpose that for which the NPDA will not override a request from the government was seen as a concern. NPDA needs to set a visionary role for decentralization, be they should have sufficient checks and balances and act as a voice for the tech and the startup community rather than just be a channel through which requests come. And then all of this requires extensive consultation and engagement with stakeholders in the sector. Whether it's for privacy harms or for what are the registration thresholds for data business, which is again a vague definition. So all of these require lots of consultation, and that is one way of strengthening the NPD framework. That sort of concludes my very short presentation. As I mentioned, the full report is up on the HasGeek website under NPD Week. Please do go check it out, and please add your comments and feedback on the research itself.